to go. Well, we love our pets, and so does our friend Mike Morse of the Mike Morse Law Firm, our new All for Pets partner.
Mike, good welcome to you.
Thank you.
Anna, Chrisman, welcome to you.
Thank
good to
you.
See you again. Lulu, and then who do we have here? You brought with you your own rescue.
My new friend.
This is Jessie.
Hey, Jessie.
Jessie is a Humane Society rescue. And we got her at the Bow Wow Brunch about 5 years ago. My three daughters were walking around as I was, you know, buying other things at the auction. And they said, Dad, you got to meet this dog. And I said, honey, we're not getting a dog. So, of course, three young daughters wore me down. Mm-hmm. And we took Jessie home.
No? Well, are you going to say no?
No, I'm not going to. And my little 10-year-old, this is her best friend. Aww. And she's homesick today. I told her I'd say hi. She's off school. But Jessie is the love of our life. And we're here to encourage everybody to get dogs from the Michigan Humane Society rather than going out and buying them otherwise.
Like Lulu.
Yes, like Lulu here. She is adorable.
She's a snuggler. I'm here for it.
Lulu's really soft. So as our All for Pets partner, you're going to pay the standard adoption fees of the pets that we feature in Live in the D?
I am.
So, oh, wow. That's awesome.
Well, we were told that there's certain people who want animals and can't afford them, and we thought what a great way to help people get dogs and cats from the Humane Society. I'd rather have them spend that money on shelter and food and veterinary care and things like that. So it felt really good. I'm a huge supporter of the Humane Society and, of course, of All for Pets and your station, and you guys do a great job. And I know that these pets get adopted pretty quickly, which warms my heart. Wow. You guys do a great job getting the message across. So I wanted to be part of it.
These snugglers kind of sell themselves. You see a face
totally
like
should.
That. Yeah, Anna Christmas from the Michigan Humane Society is back with us. And you brought in Lulu, the adorable Lulu, who also needs a new home.
Lulu is chill.
She's super chill. Like, we hopped in the car and she sat in the back and she was like, this is great. I'm going to go for a ride. This is fine. So she is a 5-year-old Chihuahua mix. Not entirely sure what we're mixed with, but I'm thinking some kind of terrier, just judging by her general
overall
awesomeness.
I was going to say Irish Wolfhound.
You know, maybe way, way back, like great, great, great,
great
grandpa,
great,
maybe.
Great, 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 great.
No, but she is, she's looking for a pretty chill home, kind of like her. So something that's got a lot of traffic, probably older kids for her would be preferable, and she definitely needs slow introduction to any resident pets.
She's super cute. All right, well, let's talk about how our pets can be like little kids and get into all kind of things. And this is Pet Poison Prevention Awareness Month. How can we protect our pets?
I know,
say that 10 times fast.
It is a mouthful. So yeah. The thing is, you make exactly that point. Pets in a lot of ways are very much like toddlers, like very young children. So same way you want to protect your toddler, keep things out of reach and locked up. That includes laundry detergents, any sort of cleaning chemicals in the house, things like that. It also includes chocolate, grapes, and raisins. Those can be toxic to your pets, vitamins, medications, that sort of stuff. And also you want to, I mean, I know it doesn't seem like it outside, but spring is coming eventually. Mm-hmm. So you have to also take care with anything that you're providing for your lawn, any sort of pesticides or weed killers or anything like that. And if you have questions or concerns about a particular product, give your veterinarian a call and they can tell you whether or not it's safe for your pet. And there is also a national poison helpline, which your veterinarian can provide you with.
Right. I think we forget about the things on the lawn and these environmental things, but they can be pretty damaging, right?
Oh, yeah. No, I had a scare the other day where my pup got into laundry detergent.
Oh.
Definitely. Thankfully, it was an empty container, so all was well. Yeah. My vet talked me off a ledge on that one,
that's
but,
good.
You know, it's scary.
I was also told about salt. You know, and what we're doing.
Yeah.
Did you mention
right.
that?
Right. Yeah.
I don't think you mentioned. I don't know a whole bunch about it. We buy pet safe salt, but
right.
I don't know how to avoid salt.
Whoa.
She's not going to bite you. She's not. That was a kiss.
You are fresh.
That's a kiss.
I was like, what's going
yeah.
on here?
No kissing. No kissing.
Did you just call that dog fresh?
Yeah, yes.
Fresh.
Okay. That was embarrassing. Jessie.
Fresh.
That was a kiss.
He's going to tease me for the next 2 weeks.
That was.
No, we're
scared.
Cool. I'm sorry, Jessie.
Oh, that's funny.
I don't know where to go after that, Jason.
You might remember last week's Pet of the Week, Kiwi, was a little Chihuahua mix, Chihuahua, rescued from California.
You know
she
what?
Was adopted just hours after appearing on our show. Look how cute. That dog looks fresh.
Oh, gosh.
You might need a break.
I just want to. I do need a break. I need a. And remember, our friend Mike Morse of the Mike Morse Law Firm will pay the standard adoption fees for whoever adopts today's pets. Thank you for that generosity.
And the Mike Morse Law Firm also would like to help you if you need legal considerations. Visit their website, 855-MIKE-WINS, or call the same, 855-MIKE-WINS, to find out if you have a case.